I'm Henny Espinosa, and this is your TFC News Now.
We begin in Southern California, where a Filipino-American lawyer hopes to become the next U.S. congressman. California's primary election is on March 5th, and FilAm Kurt Jose is making a last-ditch effort to win votes in California's 31st district, which encompasses the San Gabriel Valley and includes the cities of Azusa, Baldwin Park, Bradbury, Covina, Duarte, El Monte, Irwindale, La Puente, La Verne, San Dimas, South El Monte, and West Covina, and portions of Glendora, Industry, and Monrovia. The district's longtime incumbent, Democratic Representative Grace Napolitano, announced her retirement last summer. 10 candidates are vying for her seat, including Jose. The top two candidates will advance to the general election in November. Jose, an Oxford University alumnus, joined other candidates at the recent forums hosted by the San Gabriel Valley Public Affairs Network and the Veterans Affiliated Council. If he wins, Jose, a healthcare advocate and cybersecurity expert, could be the third Filipino to hold a U.S. congressional seat after Bobby Scott of Virginia and T.J. Cox of California.
My focus is on solutions that are tangible and that I can act on from day one, and not giving you promises that can come later in 2 years. My goal is helping you now and taking care of the problems you worry about every day. So the reason I want you to vote me on March 5th is because I'm about unification. We're not red or blue. We're red, white, and blue, and we're American, and I want to bring that spirit back to Congress.
We go to San Mateo County in Northern California, where election officials are making voting much more accessible to its immigrant communities. They are particularly reaching out to eligible Filipino voters, informing them of the different ways they can cast their ballots, and with an option to get all voting materials in Tagalog.
We make an extra effort to make sure that we're multilingual and that that information is printed, like the sample ballot, voter information pamphlet, is in Filipino. But we also have materials that go out to the Filipino press, media, brochures, all written in the language. And our website also is multilingual.
Irizarry says San Mateo County seeks to provide more ways and more days to vote. In fact, while the California primary election is on March 5th, voting in San Mateo County actually started on February 5th, when all 434,000 registered voters received their official ballots by mail.
We make it extremely easy and convenient for everyone to cast a ballot, whether it's by mail, to drop it off at a drop box, to go to a vote center, to vote in person, and to also vote electronically.
Irizarry has these reminders for those casting their ballots on Super Tuesday.
The polls will open at 7 a.m. in the morning, and they will close at 8 p.m. in the evening. Anyone that is in line prior to 8 p.m. will be able to vote. If you mail your ballot, you need to make sure that it's postmarked with a date before March 5th and that we receive it before midnight on Election Day.
And those are the news making headlines today. You can catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website, YouTube channel, and app. I'm Henny Espinosa. Stay with us, Kapamilya.